Booting up system. Loading. Gabriel Valentine. Loading. Dan Brozo. This is the Digital Lizards of Doom show live at Meltdown.
I was gonna do this dramatic raising out of the coffin thing, but kind of twisted my back there a little bit. Welcome to the DLOD Show, guys. Let's just talk about comics.
All right, Dizzy Doom's comic. Boom.
Halloween edition.
You guys like Dan's intro for Halloween? Halloween
got this
edition.
Coffin table in front of us.
You know where you can get this coffin table? Well, you can't get it. You can't own it. But you should come to Villainous Lair.
Get in on it.
You can come to Villainous Lair and you can lick it. You can like lay on it, play games
on
it.
We're getting heads shaking in the background. I don't think they want.
Oh yeah,
to lick
management
it.
Doesn't. Okay, never mind.
It is coated in LSD.
We're getting word in from management that you cannot lick the table.
You know what we can do is talk about comic books.
We can talk about comic books.
You want me to start?
No.
You start.
I'm going to start. Okay. I got the Tomorrows. It's super sick. I'm kind of doing a Dan thing today. I was attracted to the artwork first.
Nothing wrong with that, buddy.
Nothing wrong with that.
I guess it's what I do every week. So, and that's what I did this week as well.
So story is really cool. I'm going to just go through a super quick basic overview of it because there is a point I have to make about the comic book. That's really, really cool. It has kind of like a Crash feel. Remember that movie Crash?
Mm-hmm.
So there's like things that are taking place in the past and the future. And then it's almost like destiny. Like,
okay, there's like a force bringing everyone together.
Yeah, there's all these people are connected.
Storylines.
They
may
not know it or not.
Okay.
There's everything from like demons to an evil video game on a phone called Angry Gulls. Get it?
No.
It's like Angry Birds.
Like Flappy Bird?
Angry Gulls.
Like Crashy Road? No, I get you, dude. Angry Birds.
Evil tycoons. There's some pretty cool, like, Tron bike-looking things.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing about this, it's kind of hard to get too into it. I just got to tell you guys to go read it because there would be spoilers if I told you.
Yeah.
Go check it out.
No spoilers.
Check it out, right? But it takes place in, like, futuristic Japan, Tokyo, I would assume.
Mm-hmm.
Has a really cool, like, Tron-y Blade Runner-type vibe. But here's the thing I want to make, and here's why. A lot of murder, not for kids, by the way. There's a lot of murders and killing sprees. This book was dedicated to Hideo Kojima.
Nice.
Yeah. And
Metal Gear Solid, if you guys are unfamiliar with the name.
So there's that right there. It's pretty sweet. So go check it out. It kicks off right away. This guy loses his mom like right in the beginning, and mm-hmm. this little kid. It's
wait,
really
what company
messed up.
Did Hideo Kojima work at?
Konami
says
Konami.
Gabe.
Konami. So check it out. Konami. You can get it here at Villainous Lair right now in the independent
section.
That is
some sick cover art.
It's very sick. So
I'm
check it out.
Into that.
The Tomorrows.
Tight.
It's really cool.
All
put
right.
up by Dark Horse Comics, by the way.
Dope. All right, mine is from Image Comics. It's called From Under Mountains. And there's, like, when I first looked at this, I was like, oh, it's kind of Prince of Persia-y with, like, this dark spirit in the background. And then I opened it up, and there's, like, some, like, Viking-ish stuff going on. There's some Tolkien-esque
that's
stuff going
so,
on.
That's such a there's Dan comic book.
Is it?
That's such a Dan comic book.
I'm into Vikings?
No, just, like, everything about the artwork and everything.
Oh, yeah,
like,
it's,
dude,
like,
this
dark
is Dan
and mysterious and stuff.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut
absolutely.
You off.
Absolutely. There's no boobs in it yet, though. That's the one thing that could have been like, all right, this
yes.
I need to contact these people. They know me. But yeah, there's like Aladdin influences, Tolkien influences.
Whoa.
There's like it. All right. So it's basically about like this land and I forget the name of it. There's a big map in Tolkien-esque fashion. There's a map of the whole world, the land of Akkar in the back of the whole thing. And like there's one thing like the book is really cool and the characters are cool and the ambiance and the setting is really cool. But then there's like some like bonus content in the back, like just like this landscape they drew out. There's like early concept art of it. Like there's like bonus features in this comic book like I haven't really seen in anything else before. So it's like jam-packed with content. It's really cool.
So you're definitely getting your money's worth too.
Absolutely. And it's I also really like comics that have sections that are very sparse with dialogue. Like that tell the story just through the art. And that is something that, like, if they can do that effectively, then you have me hooked. And that's something they do in this book. And it makes it more mysterious, and the tone is kind of like, you have, like this what's going on kind of feeling as you're going into it. And this is the first one, and I believe it's the only one that's out right now. There might be, I don't know if it's a weekly or a bi-weekly, but this one came out last week, and it is really good. And it's just dope. Go check it out. If you like right dark on. Spirits and Aladdin
from
and
Under
Tolkien
Mountains.
And Prince of Persia.
It almost has even the Tolkien name, too.
It really
from
does,
Under Mountains.
Yeah.
That's kind of cool.
There's no dwarfs yet, though, as far as I can tell.
There is now.
Whatever that meant, yeah. We have a pretty dope guest on today,
though. We have a super dope guest on today.
You want to get into that?
Yes. Let's do it.
Let's tie it.
Arrived.
Commander Echo's guest of honor, James MacLeod. I'm not doing a Scottish accent in front of a Scotsman from Active Lifestyle Nerds.
Yes.
How you doing today,
me,
bud?
It's so great to be here.
Nice.
Thanks for coming on.
It's Back to the Future Day right now.
It is. You can. Yeah. You might even get a little bit of Back to the Future
we
sounds.
Might even get
this
video
in.
Pulled down because there's some copywritten material going on.
We'll talk
the
as much as we can so that they
bleed it out.
The few seconds that they're, you know, just
the indiscernible part.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just people clapping right now.
Right.
It could be anything. So tell us about Active Lifestyle Nerds, man.
So Active Lifestyle Nerds has been around for a little over 3 years. I guess about 3.5 years.
Mm-hmm.
It was started by a couple of guys who actually aren't from San Diego, even though most of everything we do is here in San Diego.
Shameful.
Most people from San Diego are not from San Diego, though.
Yeah, exactly.
So, excusable, for sure.
But these guys actually physically lived. One of them lived in Temecula. One of them lived in Corona.
Oh, cool.
And close enough, sort of. Yeah.
That's SoCal.
Southern California.
That works.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Amazing guys, Ricardo and Rafael. They're still involved. Raphael's still an organizer, but they did get that. They were like, oh, you guys are doing so much, we can't come down to a lot of stuff, so we're going to like kind of hand the reins over. Anyway, started about 3 years ago, right before Comic-Con, and they had a few events. Stuff that you do, if you're familiar with Meetup, is people will post bonfires or let's go get a dinner somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Or
Meetup was a huge factor, actually, in the last boat party I just played last weekend. I didn't know that until after the party, but a bunch of people were like, yeah, we heard about this on Meetup. And I was like, wow, this thing is crazy.
And so there are some huge meetups in town, social activities, 20s and 30s meetup group, stuff like that. I originally found out about them through a professional group. Like I was meeting with young professionals in San Diego and networking.
That's what their club is called, Young Professionals?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's like straight to the point, man. I like that.
Pissed off a couple of the older people that wanted to be a part of the group. Anyway,
old professionals.
Young at heart. Yeah.
Our club's called Old Professionals. It totally jacked our name.
Yeah. Anyway, so that's how I found out about that. But I signed up immediately as I saw this great event. They were doing a bar crawl during Comic-Con.
Nice.
Good time to go.
Went down, met the guys, and immediately I was like, wow, what a resource. And met a bunch of people, great nerds, everybody really friendly, welcoming. I remember meeting a professional gamer that I was excited to do and meet and talk to him about his life and what it's like. He was a Street Fighter, professional gamer.
Oh, wow.
Tons of
legit.
Money just playing video games. I was like, why wasn't that one of the things when you're taking the test in high school about what you're going to be when you grow up?
Yep.
I mean,
it will be. Like, it probably will be in,
cool.
10 years, maybe.
Yeah.
Or maybe even sooner than that.
Well, I mean, when you get, like, athlete on those things, it's like, oh, so I'm basically dumb. Like, is what you're telling me? Like, thanks, man. So, like, professional gamer is like, oh, I can play video games well. Like, come on, dude. I could do taxes or something too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But so anyways, that skill definitely branches out. There's lots of different things.
Absolutely.
So you're crawling around downtown.
Yeah. And I was
drunk.
Like, hey, you guys, this is a great resource. One thing I've always wanted to do is have a different style of a book club.
Mm.
And all the book clubs I'd been to, they're reading Pride and Prejudice or other things like that.
And yeah.
Not entirely the stuff. Of course, I've read all that stuff. I read it in school.
Of course.
Pride and Prejudice and Zombies.
Special books, that kind of stuff. yes. That's a January book. Yeah, but I was like, can I start a book club? And they were totally all over it. They put out feelers, and we had a big discussion about what our first book was going to be. Ended up being Ender's Game. They called me the morning of. They were going to do it. They were going to organize it. They called me the morning of and said that they were stuck, of course, in L.A., couldn't get down. And I ended up doing it. And out of that book club, we had about four members show up for that book club. I mean, in the beginning, most meetups have, you know, 10 to 15. The Bar Hop was big because it had like 20.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
That was huge.
And it's like booze. Right. You know, that's an easy draw. Like, oh, I have to read something?
And people walking around downtown during Comic-Con seeing all the costumes.
They're already there, yeah.
We need
yeah.
you to come to this event, and we need you to drink alcohol.
Yeah.
So who's going to be willing to show
that.
Up?
Yeah.
Funny that those are some of our most popular events. No.
Yeah, you'd never think, right?
Yeah. And it exploded. So some members from that group, you know, told their friends, and then our next book club was a couple months later because, again, the guys that started the group couldn't get down. They weren't doing a lot of events. I ended up just handling the second one all by myself, had a bunch of people come out. Those members were like, oh, great resource. Let's do other stuff. This amazing girl, Susie, really started the ball rolling.
Mm.
She was doing events like every day, every night.
Dang.
For 3 months. Totally got burned out. Couldn't do anymore. But then more people joined, and then we started with a member, Adnan, who does game night every month. Jeremy started doing hikes and...
Nerd hikes?
Nerd hikes, yeah. It's one of our biggest events. We go hiking all around San Diego County.
Whoa.
But, I mean, in conjunction with other hiking groups. I mean, hiking groups are some of the biggest meetup groups that are out
there. Is it
there.
Like cosplay Absolutely. Hiking?
No.
Because that would be cool.
That'd be too warm, though. Yeah.
Imagine going on a hike and having an in-depth conversation of who shot first. I mean,
yeah.
That's
Dude,
what...
tight.
I mean, that is kind of what I do already, like, with
right?
my friends, but that'd be cool with, like, a bunch of people.
Exactly.
Like, that'd be awesome.
Some new perspectives on it, yeah.
And in places and arenas and environments that, you know, gets you out. I mean, nerds tend to be indoor people.
Yeah.
And it was a great opportunity to get us out and get us with people that that we enjoy being around. I met my wife through Meetup.
Nice.
Oh, wow,
man. I've been to two other weddings. There are other engaged people.
That's so cool.
People find each other. It all works out. It's amazing. And so Dang. Since then, 3,000 members now. When I started,
oh,
there
man.
Was 150. And now we're about 3,400 members. It's just exploded. And we were talking about this before. Just nerd culture is growing. We're finding each other and finding out about Digital Lizards of Doom.
Yeah.
Through
that's
the grapevine,
such, a, that's
yeah.
such a funny story, man. Yeah. Like it's a trip.
But I wish we'd known about the boat thing sooner. That totally would have been an event.
Yeah.
We would have had people there.
Well, next time.
Yeah, next time.
We gotta join forces, man.
That's what we're doing right now,
that's
right?
That's what we're doing right now. So
good.
So yeah, man.
So this is only a San Diego thing right now.
It really is. We are called Active Lifestyle Nerds of Southern California.
Okay.
I think because the guys originally thought that they were going to be doing things in Riverside.
Yeah.
And in
Man,
Southern Rivers- LA.
Riverside needs something like that.
Yeah.
It is. I went to college up there for a year, and then I was like, I don't like this place. Peace out, guys. No offense, Riverside. But your city needs some more stuff going on that people like me, college kids, can like go and enjoy. That don't want to just go get drunk at house parties, you know?
That's true.
That was not my... I went to like a couple college house parties, and I was like... I don't have fun at these things.
What? Where's CSUN? That sounds really stupid.
Northridge.
That's Northridge?
Which is like near LA. Riverside is more on the outskirts.
Okay.
Yeah.
I get really confused when I go up there.
Northridge is closer to the action for sure.
Riverside's got an amazing gaming community.
Oh, I'm sure, yeah.
I mean, of course, because a lot of guys and gals, of course, are inside a lot up there. It's too hot. Don't want to do anything.
It's a weird place, yeah.
We've done wine tasting events up there.
Yeah.
Always popular. Always
yeah, wine country is real close to that area, too.
But it's of Southern California, so I look forward to the day when we're branching out and doing things. There's great nerd groups, though, in L.A. L.A.
Oh,
has an amazing nerd community. I think they have, like, the second or third largest nerd meetup.
Wow.
In San Diego, there are other great meetups. Geek Girls of San Diego, we do a lot of stuff with.
Are we allowed at that?
No. No. Sorry. All right, fine. But unless, we try to get them
unless
out.
Unless you got $25,000 worth of surgery in your pocket. Yeah. You can rip out.
Is it that cheap?
I don't know.
But our big events we try to do with them. The Doctor Who group in San Diego is phenomenal. Love that group.
Nice.
They do a lot of the viewings and we try to hook up with them. Gamers Con. I don't know if you guys are familiar with
them.
Oh,
yeah.
Absolutely.
We're actually going to be having them.
Sundays.
We're going to have them on the show actually recently. They came out to an event here at Villainous Lair, actually about a week or two ago. It was a Dress for Breast performance, and they came out, and they're really cool. I was really tired, so if you're watching this,
oh, you told me about that.
Yeah.
Like, dude, I really want to talk to you, but like, I'm just like,
I'm like, dude, we should talk Monday, right? Okay?
That's but, when you just like fell for no reason, right?
Yeah, I literally stepped out of the booth to go walk to get a drink, and my foot just dragged, and I just like collapsed, and I was like, awake, I was all strung out on rock stars, and I'm like, what is going on with
like
my
getting
body
on their mics, like we got a walker in the house.
But Gamers Con is awesome, so.
Yeah, and so they're a great group, and we try to always, when they post something, we cross post. It's just the community here is phenomenal.
That's what should happen. That's what, you know, I'm so glad we found you guys, because that's what we have been trying to get connected to, you know, and trying to like show people like, hey. And someone was saying, we had someone on the show, was it Jinx? I think it was Jinx. And they were saying, hey, I knew you guys probably don't want to promote these other clothing companies or whatever, but like you can mention them.
Yes, we
like,
do.
What? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Why wouldn't we?
Like, why wouldn't we?
Yeah. Yeah.
And they're like, oh, really?
Amazing.
And they're like, all stoked.
I was like, San Diego company.
It's the whole meme, dude. Fry, you know. Take my money, damn it. I mean, you know, it's like anything that comes out, our people are like, yeah, I'll buy that. Yeah, bring it to me. I'll buy it.
Absolutely.
Our shirts, for the longest time, wear your shirts. And I was like, no, you don't buy shirts for a meetup group. I mean, really?
Yeah. You do now. Yeah.
And so we had to do a line of shirts for a while. And
so. That's so cool. Very, very cool. Yeah. Do you guys, or do you like gaming? I know you mentioned before we started doing the interview that you guys do tabletop events.
Yes.
From time to time.
Yeah.
Do you ever like do like video games, like video game events anything like that?
We've done some events to go to, like, I mentioned to you before, I'm a League of Legends fan. So we've been to the League of Legends champion viewing events.
Nice.
We want to do more of that. I was in contact. There's a LAN group here in San Diego that do huge LAN events.
Oh, right on.
And they do get together and watch stuff. But most of that is come and play. For a lot of the... the great thing about our group is we want to introduce people to stuff, and so that doesn't usually always work out. You've got to be a fan.
Yeah,
The big viewing stuff that you can go and see now, that'll be fun. I hope it gets bigger. Like, we should be taking over bars like Buffalo Wild Wings with 1,000 TVs and getting all of the nerds together and watching something like
Abso-freaking-lutely,
that.
Dude.
Yeah, that'd be so freaking cool. There's a dude I was talking to that wants to do a drive-in movie theater-type dealio with video games.
Yeah.
So there'd be like an Xbox screen, a PlayStation 4 screen, and then a Wii screen, and you would just like have... kind of get your ticket, and you'd have like rotating people like playing like whatever the multiplayer game is. That'd be so stinking cool.
Yeah.
And apparently you can do it at a drive-in movie theater down in PB. They rent it out for pretty cheap.
Oh my
gosh.
If
you do it like during certain days of the week where like
they
usually don't get a lot of traffic. And I'm like, he's just trying to figure out how to do it right now. I'm not going to say the name of what he's doing because I don't know the details yet. But I'm like, that's awesome.
And if it's just like, well, we'll never get people to come to that. All they got to do is contact me or any of the other organizers and say, this is something we want to do. We just started doing this great event at a bar in Rancho Bernardo. Wanted to get people out, wanted to get stuff, you know, people in to learn about stuff. And it's our newbie nerds night. We, of course, get about 100, 200 members new every month, and they're not sure about the group. They want to meet us and get to know stuff. We do that. We do fun stuff. We do games. But we take over an entire bar, 50 to 100 people. The first one was like 110 people signed up. And we took over the bar on a Tuesday night. Oh, my gosh.
And the bar probably just loves you guys.
The bar is stoked on that. Yeah.
They had like, no idea that we could generate that kind of.
This is our busiest night. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that is awesome.
We were kind of talking before the interview, too, about like Comic-Con, and I was saying how a few of the people in the industry that like weren't into comic books or like nerd culture, whatever you want to call it, I invited them to Comic-Con this year because I had a few extra passes. I was like, oh, yeah, come and you'll be my guest. And they had never been to Comic-Con before, and their minds were blown at like, wait, and all they saw was money. All they saw was dollar signs, but they were just like, wait, this is like comic book related stuff?
Like, not just, yeah. But yeah.
And I'm like, sure.
And they're like, this is Comic-Con? And I'm like, yeah. I'm like, they were just blown away. I mean, I was pretty overwhelmed. You saw me
it
Sunday.
Is. Every
I was,
time.
I was toasted, man.
He was tripping over his feet.
I was like, dude, I'm...
Yeah.
I was like, dude.
Was that your first Comic-Con?
That was my first one actually inside. And
my God.
And being a part of it, because
it
was go here, go there, like every single day.
Yep.
I was there from Monday to... Or Tuesday morning to Sunday morning, I was there. Mm. So it was just like...
I had my son and his two cousins, 6, 8, and 12.
I would have been panicking.
Oh, my God.
I could not imagine
honestly,
doing that with
all these
people.
You stay close. Hands. Move. Maneuver. Okay, we're going here. Ninjago. Let's do it. Legos. Okay, come on.
Ninjago. <Yeah.
laughs> Oh, you want to see the Green Arrow booth? Okay, let's go see him. Full costume. Let's do it.
Oh,
my
man.
God. It's insane.
It is insane.
I'm glad you got to experience because it's an amazing thing. And the way we do that in the group is I have this vast network. We have like 3 meetups before every Comic-Con. We all get together. We get the printouts of the events, and we figure out where we're going, people are going to be. We know when people are in line in certain places. We have this entire network of everybody coordinating. You're going to be there this time. Okay, I'm going to this event there, and so I'm going to go over here and get in that line with you then. And then you can take my place in this room because I'll have a ticket coming out the back door, and so you'll get my ticket and then go in, and you won't have to wait.
It sounds like when I go to Disneyland with my sister. It's like like she has a map, and she's like, all right, we need to be in this line and this line this time. Yes. But here's the thing.
Latitude and longitude and stuff.
Well, the sun's going to be, you know.
And you don't want to be in that line then because you're going to get too hot, so you need to. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But when I go with her, I get to ride everything, so it's kind of crazy.
Yeah.
So, like, you guys are obviously just – everywhere right now, and you have kind of like you're like the Illuminati of like nerd culture in San Diego.
Right, there is a group of us within the nerds. Like there's Freemasons. Active Lifestyle Nerds, right? 3,300 members, but for a lot of us, it's become a family. We're all from out of town. I'm from Seattle. A lot of people are from the military, huge military community in San Diego, and so these guys are nerdy as they come. I need an outlet for that energy.
I've noticed that. I've actually seen a theme.
They're
a lot
amazing.
Of my family's in the military too, and I noticed there's so much more on board with a lot of these things. And I have my own ideas why, but I mean, it's interesting to me that it's like when they're here, it's like they're all about their family. It's like when they're not, you know, out on a ship or something or overseas, they're like, let's go to movies, let's play video games, mm-hmm. let's have fun, you know,
and so they're amazing. They make us, and so of the group of us, about 30-40 of us, we've become a family. Yes, we call ourselves the League of Extraordinary Nerds. Yeah, so there is that Illuminati feel to it of the
are controlling like what goes on in San Diego.
Yeah. But that's where it comes down to like finding out about you guys, like, and the network expanding and letting it grow. I really look forward to doing a lot more of that. That's our favorite part. Our events get bigger and bigger, you know, to sell it. Halloween's coming up. We have our big Halloween event. This is my passion. There is no better holiday for nerds than Halloween.
Heck no. I love Halloween.
Besides, of course, Back to the Future days.
But that doesn't happen every year.
Which, congratulations, by the way.
Exactly.
Back to the Future Day.
Okay, for us here. Yeah, right now.
So,
And that's been fun. We you know, come out to Halloween. We're doing it on October 30th, the day before Halloween, because we know people want to wear their costumes twice. But if they want to get...
If not just twice, then like 15 to 20 times.
Right,
I just want to be in costume the entire month of October, honestly.
That's a huge event for us. There's still tickets available. And that's open to everybody. We have an Eventbrite page. You can become a member of Active Lifestyle Nerds. Buy your tickets that way, whatever.
We'll have a link. We'll have a link below this.
Yeah, definitely.
So you can
in the
go
description.
And check that out.
Event.
Yeah,
so
what exactly is that event?
It's at 98 Bottles in Little Italy.
Good spot.
I'm so glad that we're doing it on the day before Halloween because parking down there can be insane.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so that Friday night shouldn't be that bad. Everybody always finds parking. There's a list of how to find parking. People come together. Another great thing about Meetup. Hey, I can't make it. Can somebody pick me up? You're going to find
Absolutely.
Like 12 people offer to take you. They're so friendly. Everybody's so nice in Meetup.
Man, I love that.
Yeah.
Want to go?
I don't think I have plans on the 30th. I might have some work stuff, but
yeah. I'm going to be there.
I'm
for sure.
Down. let's expand that family.
Let's do it.
Yeah. And that's fantastic. And yeah, we want everybody to come out and do that and
tight.
Have a lot of fun with it and meet us and get to know us and all that kind of stuff.
And like drink some of those 98 bottles and such.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh yes, there's going to be booze here by the way.
Yeah.
So. Let's see if we can kill all 98 bottles in one night. I believe in it for sure.
Yeah. Fun part about this year is I think we're going to have booze in like the back room too. So like last year we were only in the bars, right? And we're like, that's not going to work out as much. So we're going to have like bottle service in the back. They're going to sell like bottles and stuff.
Yeah.
So you don't have to leave the dance floor. You can get your beer, drink, and come out and do stuff. We always put out food and stuff and all that kind of stuff. Huge costume contest though. So that's the best part. And if you think anybody can costume, nerds can costume. Oh, cosplay.
Absolutely.
Lots of categories. We hope we covered everything. There's like a Marvel versus DC battle that we're going to have.
Oh, nice. My gosh.
Who will win Marvel versus DC? Who's going to have the best cosplay?
DC's going to win.
But, last year, the guy who won was a Star-Lord, and he did this amazing.
Oh, that's
within
cool.
the amount of time. I mean, Guardians of the Galaxy had just come out that summer, and he already broke out like this full-on like phone helmet, jacket, pants, and he had like everything.
That's pretty tight.
Yeah. But there was a Batman last year that was amazing, and I think he may have lost because it was almost too authentic.
Batman is surprisingly hard to do, and I didn't realize that until
it's really hard to do.
Didn't realize it until Free Comic Book Day this past year, because there was a Batman contest, and I was like, "What? That's so lame. That's so easy. It's a Batman, you know." And I was like, "Oh!" When I saw the costumes, I was like, "They were all amazing."
Yeah,
and
I thought you meant like they were all really bad.
No, they were all amazing. I was like, "Oh, dang!" Like. You can do a lot with a Batman costume. Yeah. I never even really...
And I think in the end, he just lost because of the novelty that was Star-Lord. Like, nobody had really seen that yet. And they're like, oh, no, I'm voting for that. And somebody did that in a matter of time. I think the guy invested, like, thousands of dollars in his Batman costume. It was so amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would probably just go, like, kitschy 60s Batman if I did Batman.
He actually had, like, a real Kandorian, like, like, face mask that removed itself. What are the benefits for people who might not be from San Diego? But they still want to check out what you guys do.
And they should, because what they'll see on our list is...
Like, even if they can't make it out to events.
Right. Oh, okay. Just to see what is in San Diego. So you guys mentioned tabletop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, oh my God, we have a board game bar.
Yeah.
Not that they can't come to Villainous Lair any day of the week.
Of course, yeah.
And they've got games that you can play and bring your friends in and do stuff like that. But
bring a six
to
pack,
go to a tabletop where they have fancy cocktails and great food and...
We are not alcoholics, by the way. Just keep talking.
No. It's just a nice aspect of life. Booze is cool, yeah.
You can't have a really good debate in the nerd world of, you know... Who shot first, or things like that, unless you've had a few drinks, though.
Or if you're playing the Archer board game while drinking a martini.
Right.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
And you know, Cards Against Humanity really doesn't get there be as bad as it can be.
It doesn't really go against humanity enough.
Until you've had a couple of
years. Yeah, Grandma starts, putting together the most, like, raspy cards.
Things, yeah.
You're like, Grandma! What?
Yeah.
You did what to a Smurf?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, got to have that. And so and you'll find out. You'll look at our thing. I was like, oh, my gosh, I didn't know that they would do classic movies like Halloween during this time of year at Ken Cinemas or, you know, La Jolla or this place here or, you know. And you'll find out. If you want to know where the nerd things are going on in the community, and mind you, we're just scratching the surface, check out our site. I mean, check out Meetup in general. It's a great, great resource.
That's also awesome. I'm sure you could use it as a kind of template to follow if you want to start something up like this in your own city.
Absolutely.
And I mean, I'm sure there's cities that haven't quite reached the, I don't know, 3,400 members level of having these nerd meetup groups.
But you don't need that. You need 30 or 40 people who are committed to learning about different nerd geek, you know, whatever it is that they love.
Yeah.
I think we were talking about this before too, is that nerds, of course, love to talk about what they love.
Of course.
But the nerds who are listening want to hear about it.
Yeah.
And so you can just, if you want to tell them about that new comic book or that new graphic novel that just came out and you love it and you want to find other people who are as passionate about it as you.
They're open. They're ready.
They're going to listen. They're going to go read it. they're going to come talk to you about it, and you're not going to have a better relationship with those kind of people.
It's weird because Gabe's like a member of the music community.
Yes.
And it's such a weird dichotomy. Like, music people are like, yeah, I'll share your band. I'll talk about your band. And then they never do. Yeah, I'll check out your album. And then they never do. It's like nerds will check out these things and they will go research it on their own. And if they hear it from somebody they trust or respect, then they're like even more likely to do it. Yeah. And music is like so the opposite.
I'm constantly using the nerd community as a way to try to convince my fellow musicians, like, hey man, like, if you guys want to do well, like, we should help out each other. We should cross promote. I don't understand why more people don't cross promote. The only way
There's a weird ego thing going on.
It is. It's like, oh, maybe they're going to take our fans. I have never seen that happen. I've been doing stuff like this since I was 16 years old.
I've never seen that happen. This band, but this new band came around. I'm not going to listen to that one I liked before anymore.
It doesn't even, it's logically does not even make sense.
And the people that have gotten on you guys kind of did this, you know, you put your music out there, it's available to people, they can find it, they can listen into it. I don't know anybody that's going to say, oh, I love that song, I'm not going to buy the CD.
Yeah.
No, right? Not going to do it. No, I can listen to it for free.
It goes against everything I stand for.
No. Yeah. I want to be able to create the mixtapes or the mix CDs or the mix, you know, listening things.
Playlists.
Spotify playlists.
For my friends
stuff.
To listen to.
Yeah.
Ricardo, I wish he was here, one of the original creators. He's a huge music nerd.
Yeah.
He and a couple of the other members, that's what their thing was. They wanted to go out to shows and that kind of stuff. And he did it up in LA and that kind of thing, but we never really knew about it down here, so we definitely look forward to
San Diego's a strange music scene too. Like LA people are, there's a lot of music nerds in LA. In San Diego there's music nerds, but they do it like inside their own living room. They don't go to a lot of shows, and when they do go to shows, they're not like going up and meeting the band and buying the album and buying the t-shirt. They're just like, all right, this is cool.
And there's also still, unfortunately, a lot of bands, I think, that want to be more rock stars than they actually want to make music. I know I sound like a hipster right now, but you should do it. You should do it because, you know, you really believe in it and it's something that makes you happy. And I think that that'll just bleed through and that'll become infectious to everyone else that's listening. I really do believe that, 100%. But I think there's a lot of bands that... I think that's why they get intimidated, is because they're like, well, I need to just hog everything, because it's like it doesn't necessarily feed the art. They're looking for something to feed like their own egos or whatever.
Yeah.
So I think that's mainly why they don't want to promote other bands. But I'm from a professional point, and like if you want to get way into it, I know I see you jamming.
I'm just vibing on the music. I hope this video doesn't get pulled for that.
This music stuck in my head all day long. It's been on the news, it's all over Facebook, it's all over Reddit. I mean, you can't.
It's going to be really funny if no one can even hear it. If anyone can.
I think down to nothing right now.
We'll put some background music right here, something for some other show.
I sang it a little bit, too.
But bottom line, you should support. You should support your community. It's like the economy just blows up when we like buy locally grown stuff and we like, you know, help out the craft beer. I mean, look at craft beer.
Yeah,
that's such a great example.
We have
that is
almost,
very nerdy too.
We have almost a weekly Wednesday night brew event. In San Diego, that's another come to San Diego.
Yeah,
there are,
drink some beer.
They can't go. Once a week, you can't make it to all of the breweries in San Diego once a week. You'd have to go like 3 times a week in order to make it to all of them.
You want
to
know something that's super freaky but super awesome? I was driving up north in Escondido. The 78 showed up as the Hops Highway on my Google Maps. I looked a couple times. I was like, wait, what?
Really?
And it said Hops Highway on Google Maps.
That's tight.
That's insane. That is ridiculous.
Yeah,
like that's actually a real thing now.
And so we do that. And so again, like you want to go out and have great conversation with people and check out all of our breweries. Yeah. We do that. It's amazing.
That's really cool. Get to some Twitter questions.
Let's get to some Twitter questions.
Let's do it.
You want to do your magical trick?
I'm sapped from last week.
You're sapped.
Okay. I can't do that for another 300 years.
Let's just snap then.
Okay. They're here. They arrived. They got delivered somehow. It's not delivery. It's Twitter Giorno. Okay, first one, near and dear to my heart, at Amy Wong, Rama fan.
You know her?
Amy Wong, Futurama. Come on.
You don't know the
reference?
No.
Killing me.
I don't watch
you
Futurama.
You can't do that, though.
He knows how into Futurama I am.
Oh. But even still.
Oh, I know, that's not a cool thing to do.
Rama fan.
How many times,
Rama Gabe's fan. Like my brother.
My wife's hasn't seen as much of the nerd world that there exists.
You're like, what's wrong with you?
Right. You haven't seen Blade Runner?
But seriously,
okay.
You haven't seen
We need
seen
to go
Blade
home
Runner?
Right now. Yeah. Like we're going, no.
Yeah. You know I'm an attorney, like, right?
Right, yeah.
I will sue you for
She's
not having seen
too.
It.
Oh, no, okay. No, no.
Oh, God.
Work.
We're drawing
Doesn't
up
work.
Papers.
Doesn't work. But yeah, that kind of stuff.
Okay, Dan does have a point, though. Like, this is something I should know. It is future. I mean, I do feel like there is...
Well, Futurama's my thing.
You don't get, you can get off my back a little bit about it, but...
No, we're cool now.
But...
we went through, our,
there
we went
are
through our phase.
There are some things, if you're going to be in this world... I feel like Futurama is one of those things I should know. It's over too, so it's not it's done
it's
now.
Some, it's
apparently,
fine.
So maybe you could. Yeah.
No, they said
so
they
I
said
start catching up.
If they get approached by somebody that's down to fund them, they will do more Futurama.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Matt Groening doesn't have enough money.
He doesn't even care anymore. I actually got to meet him once. He does it for what you had mentioned before, the love of making art, that's keeping it going. He doesn't need anything.
The money's a side thing. Yeah.
What's weird too is I do like Futurama more than Simpsons. Like, you know, I.
Futurama was my
jam. I just heard the hisses across the internet.
I'm sorry,
right now.
Man. Yeah,
no,
you
can't
clown
on him.
You can't.
Are you serious?
Dish it out. Dish
I'm
it
sure
out.
There's some that's, people that do. How's that? I'm sure there are some people that do. Maybe I just love it for different reasons.
Probably.
I like the themes of Futurama more than I like the themes of Simpsons. But just purely writing and the jokes and like what sticks with me over time. Like
I
quote Simpsons every day. Futurama, I watch every day. But Simpsons, I quote every day.
Well, I like Futurama because of the more like. Political nuances that they have in there, like dude, the president's heads like floating around, dude, that's just amazing. Like there's so much meat just in that little joke in itself, you know. So
all right, for Matt, Amy Wong.
Thank you, Amy Wong, for creating that awesome rant we just.
I'm already sold on this. How do I get involved? That's the first part of the question. How does she get involved, or he?
Okay, he. So, in Meetup. We have a simple rule for our group. We want to try and get to know the folks that come to our events. That's become too difficult. Even we have like 18 organizers now. I forget how many.
Yeah. You don't even know all the organizers at this point.
The organizers that do become organizers, I usually get to know pretty well.
Okay.
But all of our members post what they love.
Yeah.
So after attending three of our events, we tell everyone, post an event. And we'll work with you to get it beefed up. You know, where are you going to meet? What are you going to do? What are you going to talk about? Where's the parking? All that kind of stuff. We'll beef up the event, make sure that they know what to cover, and then we'll announce it.
Mm-hmm.
And so people that weren't organizers in the beginning are organizers now because they kept coming back and doing it. So in San Diego, we have amazing museums and movie theaters and all that kind of stuff. So some people started museum events all the time. And so then they kind of... became a museum organizer, and then movie events, movie organizer, and then so on and so forth. So anyone who comes to our events, we get to know them, and they want to post their own stuff. There you go. That's how I got started.
That's awesome.
I was not the original organizer of the group. I was the guy that came in, and I said, hey, do you want to do a book club? And then history was
forever tainted.
Yeah, I know. It was all downhill from there.
Okay, so we kind of touched on this part a little bit. Do you ever do any events in the Irvine area? That is still considered Southern California. No, you guys don't really. This is San Diego only.
We haven't done anything in Irvine. Oh, I take that back. We have done things in Anaheim, of course. We've
done
Disneyland as a group.
Oh, heck yeah.
There's a ton of great stuff in Irvine. Of course, some of the best movie theaters are in Irvine. Some of the best IMAX theaters are in Irvine.
Mm-hmm.
So what I could definitely
I remember
see
having
people,
to drive up there
right?
to see IMAX movies
right?
before we got them in San Diego.
And they're just improved. So I know a lot of the people that are going to see Star Wars have already got their tickets
That's the way
for
to do
that
it.
Theater. And that would be stuff to do. There's also other great museums and activity centers that are up there. We're totally down with doing. And so... that might be something different. If somebody in the Irvine or the Temecula or the Riverside or the Southern Los Angeles area wanted to branch out and start doing stuff with our group up there, they have two choices. One, they can start their own meetup group. Anybody can. Anybody can do that. Anybody can start their own meetup group. Hard to generate interest at the beginning. We'd be happy to cross-post and let people know about those events happening.
Take advantage, guys, if you want to do that.
Or contact me, Adnan, Jeremy, other organizers. We do have members that, of course, live in Orange and LA County that come all the way down all the time for our events.
So cool.
Yeah.
There's some great cosplay events up in Irvine. They do, you know, contests and whatnot. Anyway, yeah, totally down. We'd be up for it in an instant. I'd travel.
Get a hold of him, guys.
I could.
Hit up James.
Yeah.
And lastly, is Meetup your only website?
Well, we have a Facebook presence. I know you weren't able to find it, but we do have a small Facebook presence. We're trying to build that Twitter feed, Instagram.
They'll be able to find it after today. We will put links aplenty.
Yeah. I'll help you find that. And we have, you know, you can go to www.activelifestylenerds.com.
Cool.
And
that website was really easy to find.
Direct you right to the Meetup site.
Yeah.
I think that's our next step is we have a lot of course web creators and yeah, people who do that kind of stuff in the group. And we've talked about it. I think it would be so great for us to be able to do that because, you know, if we're going to sell tickets for more stuff or we want to do those kinds of things and have our own sponsors outside of Meetup, it'd be great to have a place to direct people. So I'm